ago in Verona, Italy, there lived two families who hated one another. The Montagues and the Capulets had been carrying on a feud for as long as they could remember.
If those Montagues should come by, I'll strike before they can run away. Then take out your sword, for two of them are coming now.
Samson and Gregory were servants of the Capulets. They were just as ready to fight the Montagues as their masters were.
I'll pick a fight with them. Stay near and help me.
I will, and other Capulets will join us if we need help.
The Capulets are better masters than the Montagues.
What? You lie!
As the servants prepared to fight, Montague's nephew, Benvolio, rushed up to them.
Stop, you fools! You don't know what you're doing!
Just then, Tybalt, a nephew of Capulet's wife, saw Benvolio with his sword drawn. He thought Benvolio wanted to fight along with the servants.
Why fight them when you can fight me, Benvolio?
I am trying to keep the peace, Tybalt. If you must use your sword, help me to separate these servants.
I do not like the word peace. I hate you and all the other Montagues. Fight me, I say. I shall be the death of you, Benvolio.
Many good citizens of Verona were tired of the long feud. They rushed up to the fighting men.
Stop them, citizens! Strike! Beat them down!
Down with Montague!
Down with Capulet!
Down with both families!
Hearing the noise, old Capulet and Lord Montague came out of their houses to see what was happening.
Look, here comes Montague with a sword. Get mine for me, wife.
No, you are too old to fight.
There is old Capulet.
Let go of me, woman!
I will not.
At that moment, Prince Escalus of Verona arrived.
Stop this fighting! 3 times already you Montagues and Capulets have upset our city with your bloody feud. We are tired of it. From now on, anyone who is caught fighting in the streets will pay for it with his life.
With this, the prince left and the people went back to their homes.
By the way, Benvolio, have you seen my son Romeo today? I'm glad he was not in this fight.
I saw him walking this morning, Lady Montague. He wanted to be left alone.
He's been doing that a lot lately, dear wife. He stays up all night long, and during the day he locks himself in his room.
As he spoke, Romeo came down the street. Benvolio went alone to talk with him.
Good morning, cousin. What is bothering you?
Oh, Benvolio, I am in love. But the girl I love does not love me. It troubles my heart.
Who is she, Romeo?
A woman who says that she will never marry.
Then forget her and find someone else. There are many other lovely girls in Verona.
No one is as lovely as she is. I cannot forget her. Goodbye, cousin. Poor Romeo. I must help him somehow.
A short time later, old Capulet met with the County Paris, a handsome and rich young man.
Sir, I would like to marry your daughter, Juliet.
She is very young, but if she is willing, I will let you marry her. Come to my feast tonight. You may see some other lady more beautiful than Juliet.
I will come, sir.
Old Capulet called his servant and gave him a list of names.
Go and invite all the people on this list to my home tonight.
At his master's order, the servant took the list and left. But because he could not read, he had to stop someone and ask for help. As luck would have it, Romeo and Benvolio happened to be walking by just then.
Excuse me, good sirs. Can you tell me whose names are on this paper?
As Romeo read the list for him, he saw that the name of the lady he loved was included.
Thank you for helping me, sirs. My master is Lord Capulet. If you are not Montagues, you are welcome to attend his party.
When the servant left, Benvolio quickly spoke with Romeo.
So, your lady's on the list. Let us go to the feast tonight. I'm sure you will see others there who are just as pretty. When you compare them, you will agree with me.
I will go, Benvolio, but not to find someone else. I want only to see my beloved.
Meanwhile, in the Capulet house, Juliet's mother ordered the family nurse to call her daughter.
Nurse, where is Juliet? Tell her I want to see her.
In a moment, Juliet walked in.
What would you like, Mother?
I would like to know how you feel about getting married.
Marriage? I hadn't thought about it.
Well, think about it now. Many ladies in Verona, younger than yourself, are already married. County Paris has asked for your hand. He will be at the feast tonight. Do you think you can love him?
I will not know until I see him, Mother.
Not long afterward, a servant appeared at the door.
Madam, the guests have arrived, and supper will be served soon.
We'll be right there. Juliet, Paris is waiting. Let us go.
That evening, Romeo and Benvolio joined the other guests at the Capulet's costume party. Mercutio, another friend, went along as well.
Cheer up, Romeo. What's the matter?
I had a bad dream last night, Mercutio. I think it was a warning.
Come on. If we waste our time talking, we will be late for supper.
It doesn't matter, Benvolio. I cannot shake this feeling that something bad is going to happen.
Inside the house, Lord Capulet greeted the masked guests.
Welcome, gentlemen. We must have dancing. Play, musicians, play!
Sometime later, Romeo arrived. Catching sight of Juliet across the room, he asked her servant her name.
What lady is that? She is very lovely.
I do not know her name, sir.
She is like a snowy dove among dark crows. My heart has not known love until tonight.
Standing nearby, Tybalt heard Romeo's low words and recognized his voice.
This man is a Montague. Where is my sword?
Why do you shout so, Tybalt?
Uncle, that man is Romeo, a Montague. He has come here to ruin your party.
The citizens of Verona think highly of young Romeo. I do not want trouble under my roof, Tybalt.
Bah, you should not allow a Montague here. As you wish, I will not fight him now, but soon he will have to pay for this.
While Tybalt argued with old Capulet, Romeo went over to speak with Juliet.
May I take your hand?
Why not? Saints kiss by holding hands.
If hands can kiss, may my lips do the same.
At that moment, Romeo and Juliet fell deeply in love with one another. Then Juliet's nurse drew near.
Madam, your mother would like to speak with you.
Very well.
After Juliet left, Romeo turned to the nurse.
Who is her mother?
Why, she is the lady of this house.
Her mother is a Capulet. This young girl is an enemy of my family. But I shall surely die without her.
Coming up behind him, Benvolio could tell that something had disturbed Romeo.
Let us leave now.
Yes, perhaps you're right. As they walked to the door, Lord Capulet urged Romeo and Benvolio to stay. They refused.
We must be going, good sir, but we are glad we came.
When the young man had left, Capulet realized that the party had gone on long enough.
The hour grows late, and I must rest. Thank you for coming, everyone. Good night.
As the other guests were leaving, Juliet asked her nurse the name of the young man she had last spoken to.
The young man who kissed you. He is Montague. His name is Romeo, the only son of your great enemy.
my only love springs from my family's hate.
Juliet!
Come, girl. The guests have all gone, and someone calls your name.
Meanwhile, once outside, Romeo could not bear to go home without catching another glimpse of his beloved Juliet. How can I go forward when my love remains here? I must see Juliet again. As Romeo disappeared over the garden wall, Benvolio and Mercutio came looking for him. He ran this way. Call him, Mercutio.
I did, Benvolio, but he won't answer me.
Let's go then, Mercutio. We can't find someone who doesn't wish to be found.
Meanwhile, in the garden, Romeo saw Juliet at her balcony window.
Wait, what light is that? It is Juliet, as bright and beautiful as the sun.
Without seeing Romeo, Juliet stepped out onto the balcony and spoke quietly to herself.
Oh, Romeo, if only you were not a Montague. Yet if you won't change, I'll deny my name and no longer be a Capulet. It is only the Montague name that makes Romeo an enemy. Take that away, and I would marry him.
At this, Romeo spoke up.
I will hold you to your word, dear Juliet.
Romeo, how did you get here? This house means death for you. If my relatives find you here, they'll murder you.
I would rather end my life from your family's hate, Juliet, than die without your love.
Romeo and Juliet spoke for a few moments of their love. Then Juliet heard her nurse calling at the bedroom door.
I must go. If your love for me is true, tell my servant tomorrow when I send him to you. Then I shall marry you.
I will wait for him at 9 o'clock in the morning.
Good night, my love.
Romeo climbed back over the wall. Even though it was very late, he knew he would not be able to sleep.
I will go to see Friar Lawrence and tell him what has happened.
Romeo, you are up early this morning. Why, I think you haven't been to bed at all.
That is right, Father. Even so, I've had a sweeter rest than you have.
Have you been with Rosalind?
No, I have completely forgotten her.
Where have you been, then?
I have fallen in love with Juliet, Lord Capulet's daughter. You must marry us.
After a few moments of silence, Friar Lawrence agreed.
I will help you, Romeo. By joining the Montagues and the Capulets, I may end the feud between your two families.
Early the next morning, Benvolio and Mercutio walked the streets of Verona, searching for Romeo.
Where can he be? I spoke with Romeo's father. He did not come home last night. Tybalt was angry that Romeo went to the party. He sent a letter to Romeo's house. It's a challenge, I'll bet. And Romeo will fight. Romeo is as good as dead. If Cupid's arrow doesn't kill him, Tybalt's sword will.
Benvolio was the first to see his friend coming towards them.
Ah, here comes Romeo.
Good day to you both. Please forgive me for running off without you last night.
Just then, Juliet's nurse and a servant walked up.
Can any of you gentlemen tell me where I might find Romeo?
I am Romeo.
I would like to speak with you in private, sir.
At this, Mercutio and Benvolio excused themselves.
We're going to dinner at your father's house, Romeo.
Tell Juliet to come to Friar Lawrence's place this afternoon. I will marry her there.
This afternoon, sir. She'll be there. I've told Juliet that the County Paris is a good man to marry, but she won't listen to me.
Good. She thinks only of me.
Tell your lady I love her.
I will 1,000 times. Let us go, Peter.
Meanwhile, Juliet was waiting in her garden. The nurse had been gone for about 3 hours.
Where can she be? She said she would be back in half an hour.
Finally, the nurse appeared.
What news is there? Did you meet Romeo?
Romeo is at Friar Lawrence's place. Go there, and he will make you his wife.
At this, Juliet hurried away. Meanwhile, Romeo talked with Friar Lawrence.
May the heavens smile upon you today, Romeo.
My life will know only joy once Juliet and I are wed.
Soon afterward, Juliet arrived.
I hope you're as happy as I am, Juliet.
Oh, Romeo, I cannot tell you how much I love you.
Then come with me, and I will marry you at once.
It grew very warm that afternoon, and Benvolio pleaded with Mercutio to go home.
I think we should leave, Mercutio. It is hot, and many Capulets are nearby. If we meet one of them, we will surely be in for a fight.
Come on now, Benvolio. You use the smallest excuse to pick a quarrel yourself.
As they were speaking, Tybalt and some other Capulets appeared. Tybalt was looking for Romeo.
Here come the Capulets. I don't care. Let them come. I would like a word with one of you.
Just one word with only one of us?
This is a public place.
Let us go somewhere else to talk.
People can look all they want. I will not leave this spot.
Suddenly, Tybalt saw Romeo coming his way.
Ah, here he comes, the one I want to see.
Romeo had just been married to Juliet. Tybalt's words could not anger him.
You have insulted me, Romeo. Draw your sword.
I cannot fight you, Tybalt. The Capulet name is as dear as my own.
Hearing this, Mercutio thought Romeo was too lovesick to fight. He challenged Tybalt himself.
I will fight you, Tybalt. Hurry before I cut off your ears. Then I am ready, Mercutio.
Benvolio, help me to stop this. Tybalt, Mercutio, stop. The prince has forbidden fighting in the streets of Verona.
Tybalt, fast as a cat, ducked under Romeo's arm and stabbed Mercutio.
Oh, I am hurt.
Then Tybalt ran away with the other Capulets, while Mercutio held his bleeding side.
A curse on the Montague and the Capulet houses. I am dying.
Easy, Mercutio. The wound cannot be very deep. It is neither deep nor wide, but it is enough to put me in my grave. Why did you come between us, Romeo? This is all your doing. I thought it best for all to stop the fight. Help me to a house, Benvolio, or I will die in the street. Poor Mercutio, this is all my fault. He was hurt trying to protect my reputation, and I didn't want to fight Tybalt because he is Juliet's cousin.
Just then, Benvolio rushed out of a nearby house.
Romeo, brave Mercutio is dead. Then I must kill Tybalt or be killed myself.
And just then, Tybalt returned.
Mercutio's spirit waits for company, Tybalt. One of us must go with him.
Then it would have to be you, Romeo.
We shall see.
The fight did not last long. In a few moments, Tybalt was dead. Seeing this, Benvolio urged Romeo to leave.
People are coming. You will get the death penalty if you are caught.
Benvolio is right. I am a fool.
A crowd soon gathered. The prince himself came to learn what had happened.
Who started this fight?
Tybalt killed Mercutio, and Romeo fought Tybalt for doing it.
At this, Lady Capulet spoke up.
Benvolio is a good friend of the Montagues, good prince. Do not listen to his story.
But old Montague answered for his son. If Tybalt killed Mercutio, then Romeo was right in killing Tybalt.
The prince listened to both sides. Then he spoke.
Romeo must be sent away from Verona.
If he is caught before leaving the city, he will be put to death.
Meanwhile, knowing nothing of what had happened, Juliet was sitting quietly in her garden.
Tonight, Romeo will climb my balcony and we will be together.
Suddenly the nurse arrived, carrying the rope ladder that Romeo would use. She was very upset.
What is wrong, nurse?
Tybalt is dead, killed by Romeo. The prince has sent your new husband away from the city.
At this, Juliet was filled with grief.
If I cannot have Romeo, I will die.
No, Juliet. Do not kill yourself. I know where Romeo is hiding. I will tell him to see you tonight before he leaves.
Meanwhile, Friar Lawrence returned to his home with news for Romeo.
What have you learned, Father?
Prince Aeschylus has given you a gentle punishment. You are to be sent away forever. I would rather die than be sent away. How can I live without Juliet? Just then, Juliet's nurse knocked and entered.
Romeo, I come from Lady Juliet. She asks you to come and comfort her tonight.
Go and see Juliet, Romeo. Someday Prince Aeschylus may pardon you. Then you can return to your home. Friar Lawrence told Romeo to leave Verona before dawn and go to the city of Mantua to live. Just be sure to leave the city before dawn. Go to Mantua for the time being, and I will contact you through your servant, Balthazar. Now go.
Thank you, Father. Farewell, and good night.
All this time, Juliet's father did not know his daughter was wed to Romeo. He made plans with the county Paris.
I will let you marry Juliet. Then she will forget about her dead cousin. You may take my daughter as your wife next Thursday. How does that sound?
Sir, I wish tomorrow was Thursday.
I will go upstairs and tell Juliet about this.
At this very moment, Romeo was standing on Juliet's balcony.
Must you go so soon, Romeo?
Yes, my love. The birds are starting to sing and the sun is coming up. If I stay any longer, I will be killed. But I would gladly stay and die for you, Juliet, if that is what you wish.
No, no, you must leave.
Just then, Juliet's nurse called to her.
Madam, your mother is coming to see you.
You must not find me here. Kiss me, Juliet, and I will go.
I will wait every day for a message from you.
And I will send one, I promise.
With that, Romeo disappeared into the garden and was gone. As Lady Capulet entered the room, she saw how sad Juliet was and thought she was still weeping at Tybalt's death.
I have good news, Juliet. To make you happy, we have arranged for you to marry the County Paris.
Oh no, Mother! I will never marry him!
In a moment, her father entered the room. Lady Capulet turned to him.
Juliet does not want to marry Paris.
What? You shall, Juliet, or I will send you out of this house.
Of course, the Capulets thought they knew what was best for their daughter. When she would not do as they wished, they left her room angrily. Then Juliet found a way to get out of the house.
Nurse, I must go and see Friar Lawrence. I have to tell him that I have made my parents angry.
That's a good idea, Juliet.
Meanwhile, the County Paris had gone to see Friar Lawrence to make plans for his wedding.
3 days is a very short time.
It is the Capulets who want to hurry.
Just then, Juliet rushed into the room. She could hardly wait to speak with the kind friar.
Ah, it's my lady and wife.
Not yet, Paris. Father, may I see you alone?
When the County Paris had left, Juliet begged the monk to help her. I know what troubles you, Juliet, and I have an answer. Drink the liquid in this vial. It will put you into a deep sleep, and everyone will think you are dead. You will then be placed in a tomb. I will write to Romeo, and he will be there when you wake up. Then, you and Romeo can go to live in Mantua.
I'll do it. Goodbye, Father.
Juliet returned at once to her father's house.
Father, I met Paris in Friar Lawrence's room. I believe he is a good man.
Then you shall marry him tomorrow, instead of Thursday.
Up in her room, Juliet drank the liquid Friar Lawrence had given her.
Romeo, I do this to join you.
Within seconds, the liquid had done its work. The next morning, the nurse went to Juliet's room to prepare her for the wedding.
Oh no, she's dead.
Hearing the nurse's cries, Lord and Lady Capulet rushed into the room.
Death has come like a frost to this sweet flower.
Downstairs, the County Paris waited with Friar Lawrence.
Is the bride ready to go to church?
She will go to church and never return. Juliet is dead.
While these things were happening, Romeo was walking down a street in Mantua. All at once, his servant, Balthazar, found him.
Balthazar, how is Juliet?
Your wife is dead, Romeo. I saw her body placed in the Capulet tomb.
Romeo was stunned at the news, but he made plans quickly.
Get some horses for us, Balthazar. We will leave for Verona tonight. Are there any messages from Friar Lawrence?
No, none.
When Balthazar had gone, Romeo went to a nearby drugstore to buy some poison. He planned to take his own life and die next to Juliet.
This is enough to kill 20 men.
Thank you, sir. Here is your money.
Meanwhile, back in Verona, Friar Lawrence was very upset. The day before, he had written a letter to Romeo and had given it to Friar John. He thought Friar John would bring back an answer. Have you been to see Romeo, Friar John?
I have bad news, Friar Lawrence. The house I was staying in was locked up all day yesterday because they thought someone had a disease that would spread to others. No one was allowed to come or go until they were sure everything was all right. The letter you gave me never reached Romeo.
What? Quick, get me some tools. Juliet will wake up in 3 hours, and Romeo won't be there.
At this very moment, the County Paris was at Juliet's tomb. Suddenly, his servant called out to him.
Sir, I hear horses coming. Then I'll step aside for a moment. I don't want anyone to see me.
Romeo and Balthazar drew near to Juliet's tomb. They had just arrived from Mantua.
Take this letter, Balthazar, and give it to my father. I would like to be alone.
I will go, sir.
When he had gone, Romeo used Balthazar's tools to open the tomb. Seeing this, Paris stepped from the shadows and ordered Romeo to stop.
Romeo, you killed Juliet's cousin, and she died from sadness at his death. You must not do anything else to hurt her family. Leave her tomb alone. Anyway, you must come with me to the prince. Because you return to Verona, you will die.
Yes, I will die, but I will do it my own way. Do not try to force me, or I will have to fight you.
But Paris would not listen. The two men fought, and Paris was killed. Suddenly, Romeo realized that the man he had just killed was Mercutio's cousin. Mercutio had been one of Romeo's best friends.
Now I know who this young man was. I will lay him in the tomb next to Juliet.
Saying this, Romeo picked up the body of Paris and walked into the tomb. Then he drank the bottle of poison. Just before he fell, he kissed Juliet one last time.
Goodbye, my love.
Moments later, Friar Lawrence and Balthazar entered the tomb. Juliet had just awakened.
Where is Romeo?
He is dead, Juliet. So is Paris. Let us get out of here at once.
But Juliet was too shocked and sad to leave. Meanwhile, Friar Lawrence was afraid to be found by the guards, and he and Balthazar left quickly.
I cannot live without Romeo, so I too must die.
With this, she took Romeo's dagger and plunged it into her heart. Called by Paris's servant, several guards soon arrived at the tomb. Another guard brought Balthazar and Friar Lawrence back.
There's a lot of blood here. What could have happened?
One of the guards went into the tomb and found the bodies. Meanwhile, Prince Aeschylus and the Capulets arrived.
Romeo and Paris are dead, and Juliet, who we thought was dead before, seems to have killed herself.
Balthazar and Friar Lawrence were brought forward for questioning just as Lord Montague reached the tomb. I will tell you what happened here, Prince Aeschylus. I secretly married Romeo and Juliet. I tried to save Juliet from a second marriage by having her pretend to be dead. Romeo was to have taken her with him to Mantua. These deaths are all my fault.
I forgive you, Friar. You only did what you thought best.
At that, Balthazar handed Prince Aeschylus the letter Romeo had given him. It proved what Friar Lawrence had said was true.
You Montagues and Capulets, see what your fighting has done. First of all, Mercutio and Paris are dead. The Capulets have lost Juliet, and the Montagues have lost Romeo. All of us have been punished because of you.
And finally, at the prince's words, the two families realized how stupid they had been.
Montague, give me your hand. From this day forth, our feud is over.
I give you my hand and more. We shall never fight again.
That is good. But for now, let us leave this place. The sad story of what happened here will remain with us always.